longer life. When you finish with it, try and keep it clean, keep it out of dirt as much as possible. You don't get dirt on it.
Yeah.
But when you come back,
wash it.
Don't add water, just clean it. Just rag, add a little bit of oil. Rag, so it will all rag so it doesn't go rusting. And that's your main things you have to pack those in your winter. And your main things from the cupboard. That and a bit of common sense. And a good attitude. Anything I'm sure about? As I said, if you're handling a cable, make sure it's a really good quality gloves on. Better your gloves, the less chance of injury for you. A cable needs to be. You have a clean up anyway. It's not bad. It's something in the maintenance. We should go through all this type of stuff. All your blocks, you've got the multi-block box in there which you use, which should be regularly maintained. Your winch. This one here has got PTO.
PTO
is
the big box in there.
Yeah. For inside at the moment. We're one outside there. I'll show you in a minute, and you'll see how it's worked. That's quite a few aircraft picture of our winners. So you need to add the hands when I come out here, but I was informed that it's got PTO inside there. I prefer the outside when you keep it on the cable.
Yeah, do it back
in. It's my own preference. If I rub rubber stamp and rain and get drenched, you know what's going on, then cables will go.
A bit of arrow there, points in position. And this one here points to the free position. So you turn it this way when you unlock them on. That says free in there. So it's lock.
Is it set
here.
Properly?
It's on.
Is it on free?
I'm halfway at the moment.
Excuse me?
Yeah, it's on free. That arrow's pointing to free up there.
Yeah, that's where it should be.
Right. So when it's on lock, that little marker there indicates the lock, is that right? You turn that round to lock. Yeah, that's locked there. Yeah.
That's in four-wheel drive.
Well, that's not actually four-wheel drive.
That's three-wheel drive.
That's just the hub locked in.
That shows it locked
four-wheel
in.
Four-wheel drive's when you get inside. It's like, so you can have four-wheel drive. Turn it back. That's how easy it is. It's there, but that's all it is. All you use. Stop the vehicle, go up to the van, turn your furthest tyre, log in, back to the other way. Yeah.
The back ones don't have that.
No.
Okay.
Yeah. So you got a choice of a four wheel or two wheel.
I'll just turn around and face that way. And
Matt Marcus.
Down these key of them?
Yeah, big map.
Oh, you know what?
Not the new map, but it's a new code.
Yes. thing goes round. When you want to take it out, you reconnect and you push it down that way.
Oh, I see. That's a lock.
That's a lock thing. Stay around. And that's your hand throttle. Shows you going in, turning out, mm-hmm. and putting back in. And you just want to give you an idea of what distance. Well, what that is, it plugs in the little box. What you're using it, I'll just give you an idea of distance. Oh. The little notch there, goes like that there. So there's only one way in there. Plug in. You're using it. Yeah. Over here. Where possible. Get behind your door and do it. So that cable breaks, yeah. You've got some protection. And if you've got someone else, if you're doing this, if there's someone over there, let you know how things are going.
Oh, that's if the cables are out too far.
Yeah.
What I mean is...
Like you never go to the point where you've got less than 5 feet rolls on the cylinder.
That's a
if you go out any more than that,
it's too far.
Minimum, leave a minimum of 5 rolls on there. But that'll reach from here, that depends anyway.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. So you've got a plenty of a fair way.
Yeah.
That's if you roll direct, that'd be virtually dried out.
Yeah.
If not double. Could it even go a bit further than that. So normally about 50 metres.
I don't think so, look at the
water.
And it's
cool. Well, let's put it this way, it goes the length of the platform at the railway station. Yeah. Length of the building. You know how long the railway building is?
Yeah.
It goes that length. When you finish, make sure there's no dirt. Just need to take a bit slow. Here we go. When you finish, make sure there's no dirt in there. Always keep the cover on. You're going out anyway. Walk around the front of the vehicle. Right, that's on. The cable will not pull you out. Make sure it's always hooked up.
That's fair.
If that's loose, flops around, unhooks, starts whipping up, you get more damage to your vehicle.
You get a fair bit of distance to play with.
It stays in the glove box. The truck's got the same. If the pointer's getting out there on a job, needing it. Oh, where's the controls? What back of headquarters? And Murphy's Law is, expect things to happen when you don't expect it to happen. Good job. I wonder if you can grab your sheets and get through the vehicle inspection. While we're out here, enjoying the sun. And if you get equipment out, always put it back where you got it from. Here's the key. Says that about things under the warranty, external inspections. Mm. I do this once a month for this vehicle.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But if we get a lot of jobs, someone thinking, just do a quick run around. Don't need, even if you don't have the paper, just go around, make sure the tyres are okay, Body weight's okay, it's plenty of oil and water. As you see, you've got the inspection sheet, you've got the date to do it, the owner with its SES, address, don't worry about, phone number. Whether it's air conditioned, fuel injected, because it's fuel injected. Yes, it doesn't have a carburetor. On your car might not be able to carburetor.
Why not have
to look at it? It's just a few little things you have to learn, we can find out. Actually, I like that, but don't
check the weather, check the seats, and look at the back of the car. Okay. Okay.
You just asked about the dipstick. Bright yellow. So it stands out.
It's usually on that side, on most cars.
On most cars, it's on the right-hand side of the motor when you look at it.
On there, the dipstick.
See the yellow?
Yeah.
That's your dipstick.
Yep.
The oil should be black.
The oil should be what?
Black.
Black.
Sarah got told the other day, but I think it shouldn't quite be really jet black.
My car oil is always black.
So
it's
mine.
You'd be with diesel. Yeah, but diesel one should always be very dark.
Oh, right.
Your car one, normally most oils are orange. At the moment, mine's black because it needs an oil change. Yeah. If it gets to black, change your oil. If it goes black real quick, take it in and get a service. The oil's burning. Yeah. Okay, as I was saying before, check your battery regularly. You know, by just looking at it, you check the terminals, make sure there's no corrosion on it.
Yeah, build above that green stuff.
Yeah. This stuff's got a pretty stuffer to stop it. Yeah. The trouble is you jump start it, it doesn't make contact. Oh. On the back. It's just easy. Open up, look in.
Be careful, yes.
Don't smoke near it. Yeah. Have a smoke or a naked light near that, or explode.
It should be covering the
corals.
Electrodes or whatever. Yeah, yeah.
And plates.
Plates, that's what it is. Plates.
You check that. This one's good. You break the container. You can see that it's full. Check your water. You don't check it here.
Is that one over here to check too? That's the plates, is it?
Yep.
Right.
And that's your transmission fluid.
What's the transmission
fluid? Yeah. Yeah. Over here, you've got keep an eye on your water bottle for your windscreen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it turns on, will wear out. You know, have a filthy windscreen. That's kept full. Keep your windows. Windscreen's clean. With your radiator of water, you don't check it here. Check it there. In your reservoir.
In the reservoir. Yeah. Oh, that's cool. In your face.
Touch that while it's hot. Expect boiling hot water all over you. And once I've told people this, I'm not going to stand back and say, oh, I told you so, but I'm going to be thinking it.
Mm.
It's easy to open that. The pressure will come through, just goes through the hose.
Mm.
As it says, never open when hot.
Yeah, park here.
Yep. That's your main thing, you just got to check. Have a look at that. Stand here, have a look here, make sure. The radiator's not too plugged. It's got a few bugs in there, but not enough to really warrant it for overheating.
I actually put some gauze in the front of my car. Yeah.
Another thing, do that on a four-wheel drive.
Yeah.
Let this be a reminder to you all that this organization will not tolerate failure.
Oops! I did it again, baby.
Yeah!
What led you through the hopelessly tangled underbrush of private security organizations to our door, hmm? Stellar word of mouth? Our fine client roster? Those flyers we put up in that public urinal?